In this video, you see the Russian T-80 tank. The crew of this tank does not know that in exactly 1 minute, they will disappear forever. A Ukrainian FPV drone is hunting this tank, equipped with a special shaped charge projectile capable of penetrating the armor of any Russian tank. The hit on the tank led to the detonation of the ammunition, and the tank exploded in just 1 second. The detached tank turret lies on the ground. Mission failed. Today, I'll show you many videos like this and explain how the Ukrainian algorithm for tank destruction with FPV drones works. You'll learn how Ukrainians have permanently changed the face of modern warfare. So let's get started. First, see how FPV drones attack Russian tanks but can't cause significant damage. Sometimes, the tank can be damaged but not destroyed. Russians abandon such tanks on the battlefield, and they can be destroyed with another type of drone, dropping a grenade into the tank turret hatch. This tactic has proven effective, but it's not the best approach. Once, Ukrainians came up with something truly amazing, an algorithm that allows turning Russian tanks into flaming scrap metal with a single hit. What if you attach a shaped charge projectile from an RPG-7 to the drone? It's an anti-tank rocket-propelled grenade designed specifically for penetrating tank armor. And what if you direct this projectile right into the base of the Russian tank's turret, into the rear area of the tank? Exactly! The tank will be immediately destroyed. Take a look at this video. It's an abandoned Russian T-72 tank near Bakhmut, and there are likely still some ammunition inside. In the video, you can see a Ukrainian FPV drone hitting the tank from behind at its most vulnerable spot, the base of the tank turret. As a result, the tank explodes and the turret detaches, soaring into the air. The tank's game over. Another incident that confirms the Ukrainian algorithm for destroying Russian tanks. This is a T-80 tank. We see the first drone hitting the tank in its front, but nothing happens. Then, the second drone strikes the base of the turret from behind, and it's the end for the Russian tank. The thing is, the shaped charge projectile penetrates the tank's armor and hits the ammunition inside, causing an immediate detonation. So in addition to defeating the tank, we also get a spectacular explosion, all thanks to the right algorithm. This Russian tank was blown up in the exact same way. A drone with a shaped charge projectile hit the tank's vulnerable spot from behind. One vivid example of this tactic was captured last summer. A Russian tank was on a mission with a full load of ammunition. A Ukrainian FPV drone armed with a shaped charge grenade hit the tank from behind at the base of the turret, resulting in an immediate detonation of all the tank's ammunition. If there are no ammunition in the tank, it won't explode, but it will burn entirely and also become useless. Note that the drone strikes the rear part of the tank turret. This is the most vulnerable spot for Russian tanks. If the drone hits from the front, as you can see in this video, the tank may survive. The Russians installed dynamic protection primarily on the front part of the tank. However, when the drone hits the tank in the rear part of the tunnel, it always catches fire. We've already seen numerous cases like these. And again, if there are ammunition in the tank, it leads to an immediate detonation and a massive explosion. Russians install electronic warfare systems on their tanks. Still, Ukrainian drones somehow overcome them. In this video, we see a drone hitting a tank equipped with an anti-drone system. From a distance, we see what happened to this tank. Perhaps it's the highest flight of a tank turret in history. It's worth mentioning another way to kill tanks. A small FPV drone armed with a single grenade can fly into the tank through the hatch in the turret. The grenade explodes and the tank burns. But if there are ammunition inside, they will definitely explode, rendering the tank useless. We are dealing with a new reality. It's amazing how a small FPV drone, which can be assembled by hand and then equipped with a regular grenade, can burn a 40-ton massive tank. Here's another such case. The drone literally fell into the turret hatch, and the tank caught fire from the grenade explosion. But let's get back to shape-charged projectiles. Interestingly, the Ukrainian algorithm works not only against Russian tanks, but also against any Russian armored vehicles. Take a look. The Russian APC-3 is carrying out a combat mission, attacking, firing at Ukrainian trenches, probably loaded with ammunition. But the Ukrainian FPV drone sneaked up from behind and hits it right in the turret. The APC exploded along with the ammunition. The shape-charged projectile easily penetrates the armor of any Russian armored vehicle. And this is the Russian self-propelled howitzer 2S19. The FPV drone with a shape-charged projectile hits the howitzer from the front. The strike causes an instantaneous detonation of the ammunition. The drone easily penetrates the armor of the howitzer. Even if an immediate explosion doesn't occur, it will happen minutes later. Whether it's a howitzer or a tank, or even an abandoned but loaded with ammunition known to howitzer, favorite is the destruction of the Russian multiple launch rocket system, Solntsepek, which uses reactive thermobaric missiles. Look, this video was shot last summer. Solntsepek is on a combat mission. The installation is fully loaded with 24 rockets. The Ukrainian FPV drone hits it directly in the ignition mechanism. As a result of the hit, all the rockets exploded. And this case is even more impressive. Ukrainian intelligence found the Russian Solntsepek preparing to launch rockets. It was decided to use an FPV drone with a shape-charged projectile. The drone strike caused an immediate detonation of the entire ammunition of the enemy installation, turning it into a large fireball. This Solntsepek is also heading to a firing position for rocket launches. But a Ukrainian drone is hunting it, and as we see, the drone is armed with a suitable projectile. The result of the hit turned out to be very, very impressive. And this specimen was hit right during the rocket launch. In the same way, you can destroy the Grad MLRS. In this video, we see the Russian Grad BM-21 launches several rockets and then move to the next firing position. But on its way, it is intercepted by a Ukrainian drone. Upon impact, the remaining ammunition in the installation detonates. Using a combination of an FPV drone and a shape-charged projectile, Ukrainians have destroyed hundreds of Russian tanks and numerous other valuable military vehicles. When Ukrainians attached a shape-charged projectile from an RPG-7 to a drone, it became a real breakthrough in military tactics. This 2.5-kilogram projectile can penetrate armor up to 50 millimeters thick, meaning any Russian tank. Its use almost always results in the instant destruction of the tank and the removal of its turret. Now, observe how the method of waging war has evolved over the past 2 years. At the beginning of the war, we all thought that the most critical weapon to repel Russian tanks was the Javelin anti-tank system. Now, we see how Ukrainian soldiers managed to stop any Russian tank with just FPV drones. A bit later, it was considered that artillery was the most crucial weapon in the confrontation between the two armies. But now, we begin to understand that FPV drones even have an advantage over artillery. Drones move faster than tanks, maneuver excellently, and hit targets with high precision. You can hide from artillery shells in a trench or bunker, but hiding from an FPV drone is impossible anywhere. Like these, they can fly into even the smallest openings and destroy the enemy's live forces. Moreover, any FPV drone with explosives will not exceed the cost of $1,000, while any Western projectile costs more than $50,000, and the Javelin ATGM costs over $80,000. Mentioning the high maneuverability of FPV drones, note how skillfully they fly into Russian armored vehicles and detonate them. Artillery is incapable of such actions. Understanding how the rules of warfare had changed, both Ukrainians and Russians have ramped up the mass production of these FPV drones. Even if Ukraine stops receiving artillery ammunition and javelins, it can continue repelling Russian attacks for a long time, solely with the help of drones. Watch this video! An FPV drone narrowly missed hitting a Russian Su-25 fighter jet. The aircraft managed to evade the drone at the last moment. Here, we see how a Ukrainian FPV drone narrowly avoided colliding with the Russian Ka-52 helicopter. There's no doubt that in the near future, Ukrainians will be downing Russian frontline aviation with drones. Russian aviation has to fly at low altitudes to avoid being targeted by air defense systems, but flying low makes them vulnerable to Ukrainian FPV drones. We hope to soon witness videos of downed Russian helicopters and planes, and to make that happen sooner, please like this video. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next episode.
Слава Україні!
Героям слава!
Разом!
Переможемо!